Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's video, we're going to talk about ratios and ratio notation. First thing to know is that a ratio is a comparison of two quantities by division. And the second thing that's important is that the order matters. All right, so anytime you're doing a ratio, which is really just a fraction, the order in which you place the numbers is very important. Another thing to know is that these ratios are going to come in three types of groupings. One grouping is going to be part to part. I'm just going to put P to P. We're comparing a part to a part. We can have part to whole. We're going to put P to W. And we can also compare a whole to a part. And I'm going to put W to P. All right. And we're going to also talk about the three different notations. The notations that ratios are put in are with a colon. So we have A colon B using the word 2, A to B, and then as a fraction, A over B. And again, where the order in which we place these numbers is very important. So let's go ahead and take a look at our question here. In a survey of 26 people, the researcher found that 16 people owned iPhones and the rest owned Androids. The important parts here are 126 is the total number of people that took the survey, so that would be a whole. We know 16 people own iPhones, that would be a part. And then we see that the rest own Androids, that's also a part, but they didn't tell us how many people own Androids. We need to calculate that. Well, if we know that the whole is 26 and we subtract off the people who own iPhones, we know the remainder of the folks have to own Androids. So 26 minus 16 gives us 10. So we know the Android users in this particular survey, it was 10 of them. So now let's look at each one of our questions here. Number one, we need to find the ratio of iPhones to Androids. Well, that there is going to be a part to part. So the number of iPhone users is 16. The number of Android users is 10. And here we see that we have two even numbers, which means they can be divided by 2. 16 divided by 2 is 8, and 10 divided by 2 is 5. So 8 fifths is one form. Another form is 8 colon 5. And the last form is 8 to 5. So these are the three ways to represent 8 fifths using the three different ratio notations. And this here is number one. Let's go ahead and do number two. In number two, we need to find the ratio of Androids to iPhones. Again, this is a part to part, and I'll just go ahead and put that here, part to part. Androids we see is 10, and iPhones we know is 16. So here we have 10 over 16. Again, those are even numbers, which can be simplified by dividing by 2. Half of 10 is 5, half of 16 is 8. So this can be rewritten as 5 colon 8, and also 5 to 8. Moving on to number 3. We want to find the ratio of iPhones to people surveyed. Well, this here is a part for the iPhones to a whole, which is everyone surveyed. So the number of iPhone users is 16. The number of people in the survey is 26. Again, we have even numbers, so we can take half of them. Half of 16 is 8, and half of 26 is 13. This can be rewritten as 8 colon 13, and also as 8 to 13. All right, moving on to number 4. Find the ratio of people surveyed to iPhones. Well, this here is going to be a whole to a part. Well, the whole is 26, and we know that the iPhone users is 16. Again, we can simplify by dividing everything by 2 to end up with 13 eighths. We can rewrite as 13 to 8, and we can write 13 colon 8. All right, let's move on to number 5. Number 5, we're comparing the Android, find the ratio of Androids to people surveyed. Well, again, this is going to be a part to, this is going to be a part to whole. The Android users is 10. The entire group of people surveyed is 26. We take half of both numbers because they're even. Half of 10 is 5. Half of 26 is 13. This can be also written as 5 colon 13. and as 5 to 13. And for our last one, number 6, we need to find the, oops, and I see a typo here, this should be ratio. We need to find the ratio of people surveyed to Android users. Well, people surveyed is the whole, and Android users is the part. So this here is a whole to part. So the whole is 26. The part is 10. We can take half of both numbers because they're even. So this here is 13 fifths. We can write this as 13:5 and also as 13:5. All right, so that sums up this video by ajspeller.com. And as always, thank you for watching.